Welcome back to Let's Play Liberal Crime Squad. Previously, shit got a little out of hand, and I'm gonna see what I can do about that. I need to take a step back, reorganize, and rethink this, because I'm not gonna let it go all to shit after that. I know normally this is where I go, and charge everybody into the police station on a killing spree, but I'm gonna do the opposite. I'm gonna reorganize, regroup, and make sure that we can survive these troubled, harsh, trying times. So bear with me while I figure out what the hell happened. Okay, somehow Lassie Luss has lost touch with the Liberal Crime Squad. I don't really know what her job was or what that was all about. I just moved Super Bestable to the Stevenson Apartments. I'm trying to consolidate all of my second-in-commands. Anybody that's connected to Captain Laser, I'm moving into the second-in-command squad here. Including Super Bestable. So, all these guys are legal, and they're all connected to Captain Laser. Now, something weird, Stevenson Apartments has 2% heat, which I don't understand, because nobody here did anything illegal. So, I'm going to take another review of the Arnaz Apartments, where I believe Captain Laser is. No, he's at the Shields Apartments, and nobody is at the Arnaz Apartments. So, I'm going to move these guys over to the Arnaz Apartments, where there's no heat. Safe house. Website team, let's fry them. Alright, so continuing on with the Organizationtron. Aha! I figured out why there's heat at the Stevenson Apartments, because our squad of hackers is here doing their stuff. And Jonathan S. Fox, who is our best hacker, hasn't got any crime, but everybody else is wanted for electronic sabotage and credit card fraud and vandalism and whatnot. So I'm considering moving them to a better place. The Old Brooks Drill Factory doesn't have any heat right now, so I may just move them there. And the Zimmerman Temp Agency is down to 500%, but there's only 5% secrecy at the Old Brooks Drill Factory for some reason, so we'll see. I'm still figuring it out. Okay, so the Brooks Drill Factory, apparently they dismantled all of the stuff here. That's why the secrecy is so low, so I'm going to put another business front up and buy some rations, and I'm going to move our hacker squad over here once I've got it better securified. We'll fortify for a siege, put security cameras, and booby traps. Not going to do a printing press for now. I'll splurge on a generator. We're down to 7 grand, though, so these guys better get to making money quick. Alright, so I'm going to move the hacker squad over to the... Yeah, it's up to 65% secrecy. We're going to move them to the Wilman Health Insurance. Yes, 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 yes. And we will set their activities, Crazy Geek. You were doing community service. And Tutman, you are also doing community service. He's the drug dealer guy. And we'll have... All my drug dealers are also just doing nothing right now, but... Okay, so you're going to go back to illegal fundraising, credit card numbers, Jonathan S. Fox, credit card numbers, Leafy Dog, credit card numbers, Asterisk, credit card numbers. I'm going to have Jonathan S. Fox do the hacking. And... M. Weiss will also do hacking. No, wait, he doesn't have enough intelligence for that. Nothing personal. You get to steal credit card numbers. Alright, and Dion, drug dealing, Nixeter. He always wants to be a prostitute. I don't know why. Well, maybe I do know why. And Rawr. Brownies. Okay, so... We've got a squad of bodyguards that are also drug dealers here at Wilman Health Insurance to protect our nerds. And then all of our second-in-commands are at the Arnaz Apartments, and none of them are wanted for anything. Winter McBigtits, Mr. Fancy Pants, No Lock Clobber Aches, and Super Bestable. Well, Super Bestable is not really a second-in-command. He's more just a tailor. But... Captain Laser is still not wanted for anything. He's over here at the, I need to regain him some juice, but I can't do that legally. He's starting to have juice reduction or whatever. But, Anyway, we're going to move on and see if we can figure out what to do next. Okay, I'm going to have Captain Laser go out and hopefully recruit some writers to write for the printing press we have over at the Zimmerman Temp Agency. But I'm going to do that off-screen because that's going to take a while. But until then, we will be back with Writer Squad. Okay, the Writer Squad is Jedin V, Dowd Pride, Sable, and Coronel Neal. I don't know why he spelled that way, but it's not my fault. I didn't do it. Okay, so we're going to have them set apart to do writing, liberal activism. We'll have... See, he's only got 5 writing skills, so I'm going to have him just write to the newspapers for now. And Jedin V... Wait, no. Dowd Pride will do... Wait. He's got 3 writing skills, so he's also just going to write to the newspaper. But Sable and Coronel Neal are both authors, so their writing skill is 7, so they're going to write for the Liberal Guardian. And his writing skill is 6, and he's going to write for the Liberal Guardian. Okay, so we've got some writing guys, and I kind of want to get a squad that's just dedicated to doing just liberal disobedience, so I'm going to find out who among our second-in-commanders has lost their squad and get them to do a squad of people who go around throwing buckets of red paint on people in fur coats. And for our special edition of the Liberal Guardian, we will serve up some... judges corrupt evidence. Taking bribes to acquit murders. That's a serious charge. Alright, first I decided to finish up our... Oh no. He doesn't have enough leadership skill. Okay, well, I went ahead and added another writer to the squad of writer people. I'll have to send him there anyway. So after this, I'm gonna get that squad I was talking about to do the liberal disobedience. Okay, so Winter McBigtits has got room for 10 more people, so I'm going to recruit a whole bunch of hippies at the vegan co-op, because they have high heart. And, hello, hippies. Yes. And I'm going to have them do the liberal disobedience stuff. They may get rolled for some vandalism or something like that, but in all honesty... You know, that's never going to stick to Wenchy McBigtits. She's got enough law skill and other stuff, too. That stuff will just slide right off of her. So we'll get a couple more hippies, and then head back to base. Alright, so recruit ho! Okay, so we've got all of our usuals doing donations, credit card fraud, brownies, hacking, volunteering. And now we've got Jedin V, Dowd Pride, Sable, Coronel Neal, Vendane doing writing for the Liberal Guardian and for other newspapers. And then Winchy McBigtits recruited 9 people to do trouble causing and making graffiti. And I guess DeKratos is attacking a website. I'm going to have to change that. But I'll go through all of their names. I just want you to do liberal disobedience. Okay, so Zombat, Spook, Zalter, Sinjin, Oddloki, Gumball, Shadow Luigi, Notmet, Gator Boy, and DeKratos X. Alright, now, we had a problem in Z-Sword, because he's connected directly to Mr. Fancy Pants, which isn't good, and we used him for vandalism and for carjacking. So I think what I'm going to do with him is going to be a little risky. I'm going to have him become another commander under Lord Fancy Pantaloons. Or, not Lord Fancy Pants, Mr. Fancy Pants. And I'm going to have him go get a bunch of juice and then recruit another squad. And then, before he recruits another squad, I'm going to have him go turn himself into the police, and we're going to hire a high-powered lawyer to defend him, because his law skill is only 1, and he's only got 6 charisma. So, and for some reason I have him in a black robe with a gavel, I don't know why. But anyway, that's the plan for now. We've got our guys doing liberal disobedience, hacking, we've got money's not a problem, and we're going to have a risky bit of stuff to try to get Z-Swords not only in commander mode, and also free of any illegal activities. So next time on Let's Play Liberal Crime Squad, we continue to rebuild our damaged organization, which is slowly but surely coming back to life and becoming a threat to conservatism everywhere. All right, join me next time on Let's Play Liberal Crime Squad, where we play more Liberal Crime Squad.